ओके. नाउ द नेक्स्ट जनरली एक्सेप्टेड अकाउंटिंग प्रिंसिपल मीन्स कंसेप्ट, गोइंग कंसर्न कंसेप्ट. हियर इट इज अज्यूम दैट द फर्म वुड कंटिन्यू टू कैरी आउट इट्स बिजनेस ऑपरेशंस फॉर ए फेयरली लॉन्ग पीरियड ऑफ टाइम एंड वुड नॉट बी लिक्विडेटेड इन नियर फ्यूचर. It is assumed that the enterprise has neither the intention nor the necessity of liquidation. It means the transactions are recorded in the books of business on the assumption that it is a continuing enterprise. Due to this concept, we record fixed assets at their original cost and depreciation is charged on these assets without reference to their market value. I can give you one example. If a machinery is purchased which would last say for next 10 years, the cost of the machinery will be spread over the next 10 years for calculating the net profit or loss of each year. म्हणजे जर आपण मशीनरी परचेस केली तर तिची जी कॉस्ट आहे ती 10 वर्षांवर स्प्रेड होणार आहे. ह्याचा अर्थ ती मशीनरी 10 वर्ष आपण वापरणार आहोत, तर आज जरी मशीनरी परचेस केलेली असली तरी तिची कॉस्ट ही 10 वर्षांसाठी वापरली जात असल्यामुळे 10 वर्षांच्या डोक्यावर स्प्रेड होणार आहे. बिकॉज ऑफ दिस कन्सेप्ट ऑफ गोइंग कन्सर्न द फुल कॉस्ट ऑफ मशीनरी वुड नॉट बी ट्रीटेड ॲज एक्सपेन्स इन द इयर ऑफ परचेस. ज्या वर्षी परचेस केली त्याच वर्षी ती मशीनरी परचेस केलेली अमाऊंट आपण एक्सपेन्स म्हणून धरत नाही, कारण ती 10 वर्ष आपण वापरणार आहोत. लक्षात येते तुमच्या काय म्हणायचं आहे मला ते? त्यामुळे ही जी कॉस्ट प्राईस आहे ही त्याच वर्षी खर्च म्हणून टाकली जात नाही, कारण द मार्केट व्हॅल्यू ऑफ फिक्स्ड असेट इज इररिलेव्हंट and it is not recorded in the balance sheet as these assets are not going to sold in near future. Manje aankhin ek example mi deu shakte. It is also because of this concept that outside parties enter into long term contracts with the enterprise. They assume that the firm's intention is not of liquidation or the financial institutions gives loans for long term following this concept. Okay, now the next concept, accounting period concept. Accounting period, it refers to time span. It refers to the span time at the end of which the financial statement, here is a printing mistake, it should be financial statements of an enterprise are prepared to know what is the profit or loss earned by the firm at the end of that period and what is the position of assets and liabilities of the firm. Normally it is of 1 year. We all know that financial year of every firm starts on 1st April and ends on 31st March. These 12 months is the time span of the firm. Ascertainment of profit after a very long period will be of little use to the users of the accounting information, that is proprietors, manager, investors, etc. because it will be too late to take corrective step after so long time. The users of financial statements need to know the results of the business at frequent intervals to take the decisions. So the entire life of the firm is divided into time intervals for the measurement of profit of the firm, profit or loss obviously. So 12 months period is usually adopted as the calendar year is of 12 months. They have adopted 12 months period as a lifespan, as a time span for accounting purpose. After completion of 12 months, They prepare financial statements from the records of the accounts and calculate profit or loss of the firm at the end of that period, that is on 31st March. Okay. Now the next concept, cost concept. This concept requires that all assets are recorded in the books of accounts at their purchase price. It means, according to this concept, when the asset is purchased, it is recorded in the books of accounts at the price at which it was acquired. This acquisition cost becomes the basis of all subsequent accounting for the asset. This acquisition cost also includes transportation cost, installation cost, and making the asset ready for use. So total price is considered as purchase price and recorded in the books of accounts as the value of asset. This concept is historical in nature. It is said as historical cost because this cost is related to past. So it is referred to as historical cost. For example, I will give you one example. If a business enterprise purchases a building for rupees 20 lakhs, it will be recorded in the books at rupees 20 lakhs. Subsequent increase or decrease in the market value of the building would not be recorded in the books of accounts. However, this cost is systematically reduces from year to year by charging depreciation, and assets are shown in the balance sheet at cost less depreciation amount. Okay.